Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Edge Sports Network. Hope you guys are doing good. We got another interview for you guys today, part of our summer series. We got Antonio Daye Jr., FIU guard. Antonio, thanks so much for joining us here on the site today.
Thank you for having me.
No problem at all. Our pleasure. Great to have you on. We'll start off here. I mean, it's been a unique offseason, I'm sure, with this pandemic going on. Things have been kind of mixed up and whatnot. How have you kind of been staying busy? How you been doing in general? And, you know, what's this upcoming season looking like for you?
Well, I've just been staying in the gym as much as I can and just being precautious of the viruses out there and being aware of people I'll be around. But like I said, I've just been in the gym constantly and keeping my mind active with just playing ball and just watching movies and just enjoying my free time that I do have. And the upcoming season, I'm looking forward to it if it even happens, because I feel like I got a lot to prove with my individual stats and also with just being able to lead a team now that, like, I'm the key guy with three of our seniors leaving. So I'm looking forward to that.
For sure, for sure. No doubt about it. I mean, you're coming off a great season right here, and I know it's good to see that you're keeping with it this offseason, staying safe, staying healthy. That's the most important thing right there. I mean, last year, though, you really did have a great year. You know, averaged 11 points a game, 3 rebounds, 5 assists, shot the ball well at 41%. You know, what did last offseason kind of look like? You had a great first year as well, but you made quite the jump last season. So how that offseason kind of go? Was your first offseason, you know, where you were kind of immersed in that college basketball atmosphere? So what did training look like for you? Did you switch anything up from high school?
Yeah, definitely. After the first year, the first year was kind of like a learning year for me, just like most freshmen it is. So that upcoming summer, I just like put a lot of pressure on myself, and I just was very hungry to want to just like be the best point guard I can be. So I worked on like pretty much everything. I went and reinvented myself, but also stayed the same, if that makes sense. So like it was a grind, and the work paid off luckily, and I'm looking forward to making an even bigger jump from my sophomore to junior year.
No doubt about it. You made a really nice improvement last season. 2 years deep in the program now, still really early on in your career. Got 2 years to go here. I know what I love about your game is you really have kind of a well-rounded, just overall game here. I know back going to high school here, you were Defensive Player of the Year all 4 years of high school. You also MVP your sophomore, junior, and senior season. Had a great senior year down in Florida. Great 3 years over in North Carolina there, but how do you kind of focus on both sides of your game? We see a lot of guys out there focus on maybe just defense, just offense, but you're really well-rounded all around. So what kind of goes into making sure that each part of your game is toned up, ready to go for the season?
Well, it first starts off with just taking care of your body and just taking care of your mental health, because that's the most important thing. But defense has always been like my main focus. So, like, that was my main focus always. I love defense. It gives me a rush. It just gives me, like, a great feeling. So, in the offensive end, I was just blessed enough to have the offensive ability, and I work on my game a lot, so it just pays off. But, like I said, like, the defensive end is my favorite part of the game, and it leads to offense.
Exactly. I mean, you have that. You know, that's one thing. Defense always kind of translates to offense right there. You play good defense, you're going to get those offensive opportunities on the other side of the ball, make it much easier for yourself, for the whole team. That's shown in your high school career, leading into your college career here, showing your first 2 seasons at FIU. I always like to ask about the college decision, too. I mean, you were recruited by some pretty impressive teams. I mean, Rutgers, Clemson, Old Dominion, Western Kentucky, just, you know, I know there were a few others in there. What kind of led you to FIU? What made you decide to continue your basketball career there?
Well, yeah, it was a couple things, but some of the main things were I was already get down here for high school. As you know, I went to Fort Lauderdale High School, which isn't too far from Miami, so I was kind of familiar with the area already. And then guess when Coach Babler and his staff got the job, when they reached out to me, I knew that the kind of offense and defense they ran, because they were at BCU, which is like a full-court defense and get out in transition and run and kind of run the NBA offense. So that definitely, like, sparked my interest a lot, because I plan to be in the NBA one day, so why not get a head start now with being in the system and getting used to it? And like I said, like, I love defense, and their, like, main focus is getting after it on defense full court. And also, I just didn't want to, like, go to a big school that was used to winning or used to having a winning culture and I wanted to go somewhere where I could start my own legacy and, like, kind of change the program around myself and make a name for myself and do what a lot of people can't do, which is make it from a mid-major school.
You've certainly done that in your first two seasons. I mean, you guys went 19-13 last year. I'm sure you're looking to kind of build upon that this upcoming season. Let's hope we have a season. I know I'm hoping everything goes well for you guys, you know, schedule-wise and whatnot. I hope everything's as normal as possible. Going into that first season, I know you had a really good year. We'll get into that a little bit. But when you're headed into college basketball, what were you most nervous for and what were you most excited for?
Well, honestly, the thing I was most nervous for was just kind of like being the new guy. But as far as like my basketball abilities and things like that, I pretty much knew and was confident in my work that I put in that I would be ready and prepared for it. So it was more so just meeting new older guys. You know, in high school, it's pretty much everybody's your age and you're pretty comfortable. And I was like the main guy, you know. But coming into college, I was the youngest guy on the team. I was the only freshman. And I was meeting a whole new group of guys. So that definitely was probably the most nerve-wracking thing for me coming in.
Yeah, I mean, you looked really comfortable. And
So
when you looked that comfortable, I mean, how'd you kind of prepare for that first seed? Is it kind of – I know you got to prepare physically, but how's the mental preparation too?
It's just all about confidence, to be honest.
The
confidence plays a huge factor in that. Like, from the first day I got on campus, I kind of just marked my territory with just letting guys know that, like, yes, I'm young, but I'm here to work and learn and to play my role. So that kind of, like, let the guys that were here before me know that, like, I was ready to work and, you know, they would be able to put their trust in me and be able to trust that I would have the program in good hands when they leave.
I know when you're headed into that first college game, too, I mean, you come in, what's the atmosphere like? You know, game one of college basketball, it's, I'm sure it's something you work for your whole life. Step out on that floor, come out of the tunnel. How's that feeling? And do you kind of remember the emotions that you were feeling, you know, pregame and just warming up and stuff?
Yes, for sure. It definitely is nerve-wracking. It's a great feeling. It was a blessing. I just had a lot of emotions running through my head with excitement, nervousness, like sad. It was a good sad. It was just sad because, like, I never would have dreamed of being a Division I basketball player. Let alone playing in a great place like FIU in Miami. So it was definitely nerve-wracking, but it's no feeling that I can describe that was the same feeling as that. It was a great moment, and I'll never forget it.
No doubt. And, I mean, your first year here, you played in all 34 games. I know making that transition from high school to college, as you mentioned, a little bit nerve-wracking, but it's kind of like that good-bad that you mentioned. You know, you're excited. You're ready. It's what you've been working for. You started quite a bit of games in the second half of the season. I think it was 18 out of your last 20 that you actually started. Going into those starts, what's the preparation look like? I'm sure it's a little bit different, especially for your first college start. How'd you kind of get ready for that, and how'd you prepare yourself for that game?
Well, I actually didn't even know I was going to start that game or anything because Coach Bella had always told me from, like, the first day I got here that, like, my talent was a starter talent. Like, he just told me to be patient and trust that he have a vision for me. So, like, I was just always on the bench ready to go whenever my name was called. And, like, I remember the game. I think we were playing Middle Tennessee, and it was halftime. And, like, one of the starters, like, had got injured or something like that and couldn't play the second half. So I had came out, and Coach Dallas had told me I would start that half. And I did really good. I had, like, 15 points that game, and, like, I had made some great defensive plays, and I had played really good, and after that game, he kept me in the start lineup, and, like, I was just very happy and blessed for it, and I knew that I had worked very hard for it, and I was excited, but I definitely was nervous because it was a new role for me. I knew that there was more pressure on me as a freshman and now being in the start lineup, so it was definitely nerve-wracking, but I was up for the challenge, and I think I handled it pretty well for the most part.
I'm sure that's kind of a moment you'll always remember right there, and you did handle it very well. I know, especially in your first year of college basketball, I don't think a lot of guys can come out, start a game, and just kind of stay cool, calm, and collected. Because, I mean, you're fresh out of high school at that point, and it is a big transition, Division I college basketball. I know I've talked with a lot of guys. It's a different pace of play. There's a lot of things that they don't really realize until they actually get out onto the floor. And at that point, it kind of hits them, all right, new level right here. We're in college basketball. Got to be on task every single play, every single minute of the game. So it was nice to see that you made that transition pretty smoothly, and it's carried over into your sophomore season. Probably going to carry over into your junior year here as well. And I know you've only played 2 years in the program so far, but what are kind of your most memorable moments that you've had in these first two seasons so far? Anything that, you know, really stuck out to you? What are kind of some of your favorite memories with this program?
I have a lot of memories, but if I had to pick a couple, I would definitely say the first time I got to start. Mm-hmm. That was definitely a surreal feeling. Also, just even my sophomore year, when I knew that, like, kind of this was kind of my team now, as far as, like, me being the starting front guard, and, like, my first game was just, like, very exciting to me, because, like, I knew that it was a new journey for me and a new challenge for me to accept. And if I name one more, I would have to say just when we beat Rice in the conference tournament this mm-hmm. year before, like, the COVID happened and we had to end the season, like, that game was pretty intense, and, like, it means a lot to me to know that, like, we ended our season on a win, and, like, I had a pretty good stat line that night, which mm-hmm. helped my team win, and also I let my seniors leave on a winning note, so I felt good about that. That was, like, a really good moment for me.
Great win for you guys. And in that conference tournament, I mean, how was that atmosphere? Is it a step? I'm sure it's a step up from the regular season, but going into those games, I mean, those are kind of the things that you grow up, I'm sure, kind of wanting to be in right there. Those are the situations every kid shooting basketballs in the driveway kind of looks forward to. I know, you know, kids growing up, they're putting that ball up, pretending, you know, buzzer's going off in those conference games, those conference championships, whatnot. How was that tournament atmosphere? You know, how was that experience for you?
Oh, man, it definitely was something I'll never forget. Playing Rice was, like, it was nerve-wracking, because Rice was one of the teams that, like, you couldn't sleep on. They mm-hmm. weren't the biggest team. They weren't, like, the fastest team, but, like, they shot the ball great, and they were just a great team overall. And my best friend happened to play for that team, so, like, to be able to play against him that first round, it was, like, a great feeling to be able to do that. And the Dallas area, it was a whole good vibe, you know. Mm-hmm. So it was definitely nerve-wracking, like everything else, but it was fun, and it's something that I'll never forget.
I'm hoping that you get more opportunities like that in the future. I'm sure you will. As I mentioned earlier, you guys are coming off a really good season. Certainly something to work off of, to build off of it. And I know you're probably looking forward to this upcoming year right here. You're headed into your junior season. You're going to be an upperclassman, pretty much the leader of this team. Guys are going to be looking up to you now. What are you kind of looking forward to this upcoming season? What are some goals you have personally and for the team?
Well, definitely, for the team, I'll start with the team goals. I definitely want to take my guys back to another postseason tournament, whether it's the CIT or the, obviously I want the March Madness, but mm-hmm. I'll be content with just any postseason, another 20-plus win season. And I just want to, like, kind of make my mark for the freshman that we have, because when I was a freshman, I really didn't have a lot of, like, mentors here at FIU, like, as far as the players. So mm-hmm. I kind of want to make sure that I'm a mentor to some of the upcoming freshmen and some of the new guys that we have. And as individual goals, I want to, like, pretty much add a statistic to every category. Like, I want to score more points this year. I want to average more assists and lead the league in assists again. Mm-hmm. I want to lead the league in steals. I just want to do whatever I need to do to help my team win, and just be a guy that does whatever the team needs on any given night.
And going back to kind of your just all-around style of play on both sides of the ball, so I think you'll be a great leader for guys to look up to, those younger guys coming in, those younger guys that have already had a season under their belt coming in this year for year two. So as an upperclassman, I'm sure that you're going to serve those guys well, serve as a good mentor, and, I mean, your team chemistry looks really good. Can you explain what it's like just kind of in the locker room on practices and stuff, how you guys have really established that strong team chemistry?
Well, with this COVID-19 going on, we have been, like, pretty much stuck on campus and stuck in our room for the most part.
Mm-hmm.
We're only allowed to go to the gym and food and dorm. So with that in effect, we have pretty much just been around each other all day, every day. So we've been bonding pretty good, and the new guys have came in and adjusted very well. They're good guys. They're funny, and we're always just laughing and having a good time. And it's nothing about basketball. It's all just everyday life stuff, and that I think that carries on to the court. When you feel comfortable with somebody off the court, the on the court chemistry becomes just like second nature.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. No doubt about it. And you guys seem to have built that team chemistry in the off season, because this year you were fantastic. And I know this off season right now, I'm sure it's pretty tough to kind of keep things relatively normal, be able to connect a little bit with that, pandemic going on and stuff. I know a lot of guys in different programs have been kind of doing different things. I know mostly it's been Zoom calls and stuff, but you said you're on campus right now?
Oh, yes, correct.
That's good. I see. That's good then. And you can kind of maybe establish some more team chemistry right there, because I know a lot of guys haven't even traveled out to their schools yet. So they're off campus, and that's definitely going to be a fiasco, traveling and whatnot. So the fact you're on campus, kind of getting in that routine early, definitely a positive thing, I think. I like to end the interview, wrap it up with a few fun questions, and then one question right at the end that you might have to think about a little bit. You might have thought about it before, I'm not sure, but we'll get there. First question for you here, though, is your uncle, Jawad Williams. I mean, UNC national title in 2005. He was part of that national championship team, and then he went on to play in the NBA. I know he's playing overseas. Can you just talk a little bit about his impact, just growing up throughout your career? I know he's definitely served as kind of a role model for you. He's been very successful on the basketball court. So what has he kind of, taught you throughout your life, taught you on and off the court, in order just for you to get to where you are today?
He's a great role model for me. He's always there when I need him for advice, and he always just give it to me real. I never have to worry about him sugarcoating anything or telling me what I want to hear. So like anytime I'm having a slump, whether it's in practice or in games, or whether if I just feel bad about anything with basketball related, I always can go to him and he gives me great advice, and he just tell me the things that he had experienced when he was in college. And just life stuff, he just tells me, that every decision I make will be something I have to live with. And he's always just gave me great life advice as well that can carry on to basketball and life. So he's definitely been a great help with that. And as far as like basketball, when I'm working out and stuff with him and seeing his work ethic and seeing how he takes the game and approaches the game every day, it kind of motivates me a lot to work even harder than what I am working, because if he's doing that, he was in the NBA for all those years, I know that I can be doing that time too, because I'm trying to get where he's at or was at.
Seems to have kind of taught you some great lessons that you're carrying on in your career, on and off the court, for sure. And you're definitely on the right path. You've set yourself up really nicely here. Second fun question I always like to ask. One thing that people don't know about you, I mean, what's a fun fact right here about Antonio Daye Jr., something that the people might never know if you hadn't said anything about it?
It's something that I would have to say that I'm a rapper.
Oh, really?
I think I am at least.
There we go. There
Yeah,
we
I love to rap or try to. I do it like on my spare time.
Excellent. Are you gonna be dropping any music soon? Like, that's the real question here.
Yeah, I'm in the works with something. That's all I'm gonna say. I'm in the works with something.
Right, you gotta send it to us, because we'll promote that for sure. I mean, we'll get that out there for you, no doubt about it. And
Also, if another thing is, I just currently started a YouTube channel, so everybody that's listening can check that out. It's the official Antonio Day. I just started that, but that's another thing that a lot of people wouldn't know.
Excellent, excellent. We'll make sure to go subscribe on our YouTube channel then, for sure. So we'll get that
I
there,
appreciate that.
and we'll share that around. We'll put that down below for everyone, so they can go check that out. Actually, we'll put a link to that right down below. So we'll
I
have
really
that.
appreciate that.
No problem at all. We'll have that right down below for you. But yeah, did not know that, so that's good to know. And yeah, we'll definitely. And as I said, once the music drops, you gotta send it over. You gotta send it over. So
Definitely will.
good, good. That's what we're looking forward to right here, and we'll definitely promote that as well for sure. So you heard the man. Everyone go subscribe on YouTube, and when the music drops, we'll have it here. Make sure to check that out. But we'll have that ready. Don't worry about it. So I always like to end here. I mean, this is the million-dollar question, Antonio. Might be a tough one, might be easy. As I said, you might have thought about it. I know it's pretty broad, but it's a pretty good question, I think. So looking back at your life here, looking back at your basketball career, what has basketball meant to you? If you could sum it up in a word, a sentence, a phrase, how would you kind of describe it?
Well, I'll give you both. I'll give you a word and a sentence.
There we go.
If I just name a word, I would say a blessing, definitely, just a blessing. And a sentence, it's been everything that I could ask for and more. Like it introduced me to great people. It took me to places I never would have went without basketball. it changed my life, literally. It probably saved my life, honestly. I take it serious, and I'm grateful for it.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, that's pretty much it. It sums it up for the most part.
Great way to describe it. I want to say congrats on a great first two seasons with FIU. You've looked fantastic so far. Wishing you nothing but the best this upcoming season. Hoping you guys get started on time. But really looking forward to seeing what you guys do on the court, what you do on the court. Nothing but the best of luck for you. I hope you continue to stay safe and healthy during this time as well. And I hope everything goes well. You know, as the season comes to a start here, hopefully everything stays on time schedule-wise. But Antonio, I mean, thank you so much for joining us here on the site today. It was absolutely great to have you on, and we'd always be happy to have you on again.
I really appreciate it. Thank you guys for having me.
No problem at all. We'll put your Twitter down below so people can follow your career journey. And as I said, we'll also put the YouTube down below so people can go subscribe and check that out. And we'll have the music when that comes out, don't you worry. But guys, thanks so much for joining us here on Edge Sports Network. We'll also put a link to FIU's website for their basketball page so you can follow for news and updates on the team, as we always do with the teams we cover. But guys, thanks so much for joining us. As always, we'll see you guys next time.